class is called Robot Design and Experimentation, and it gives graduate students an opportunity to take what they've learned in other classes here at Carnegie Mellon and apply it to a large robot project. This year, the theme for the class projects was bio-inspired robots. And so the first week, the class took a field trip to the Pittsburgh Zoo, where the students were able to meet different animals, take notes, and come up with project ideas that then led to the specific projects that they're working on now.
Our project, as you see here, was inspired by the sea urchin and how it moves.
We are doing a flying squirrel robot.
The galago in nature is an animal that has elastic legs or tendons.
What we're doing is we're building a falling cat robot.
So the students will be implementing different control methods, optimizations, design tools, in order to build and test a complete robotic system.
So first we start with like conceptual designs, and then we turn it into like cat model to see if it actually fits. After the cat model, we do the simulation based on the cat model. After the simulation, we order parts and assemble things, test and see the problem it is, and then redesign and test. That's basically our process right now.
You know, when a kid gets a robot, oftentimes they're not actually creating the model or the device from scratch. They're actually just programming commands. Programming commands on an existing robot is easy. Programming commands and creating the robot in which you're going to program commands is an iterative process, and it's fairly difficult.
So it turns out that teamwork was very important to the success of this project because there are a lot of different parts, and especially the task that we are trying to tackle has a lot of different components that any one person could not do all of them. And so it's very important that at the beginning we kind of all sat down and made sure we were on the same page about who would be doing what and who would be bringing which talents to the table. That's another focus of this class, is a way for graduate students to bring something into a project that they might have learned in a class but not been able to apply previously.
As far as a team, it's actually been really good. Myself and another teammate have a lot of modeling and simulation background. And then we have the majority of the team is really good at hardware and electronics and interface.
So specifically in this class, we're focusing on experimentation as well as design. So part of the class itself is defining that goal. And we spent a lot of time towards the beginning asking, what is the research question that we hope to answer so that we do have a specific goal that we can kind of measure and quantify our success.
The nice thing about this project was that Professor Johnson assigned a very open-ended design requirement. He gave us the direction of make a robot that can fulfill an experiment that is somehow bio-inspired. So that really opened the doors to anything.
It's just like a really novel experience for me. So I've done some other like robot design, and they all have like a set goal. You know what you're gonna do. It's not like a research project. For this one, you have to like make your own research questions. You have to make your own objectives. And based on that objective, you're gonna see how much you can achieve. I've never done something like this before. It's pretty interesting for me.